Hey, how's it going, guys? This is Eckyman, and welcome back to This War of Mine. Okay, so today is the official release day. The game is now available for purchase on Steam. You can find a link to the game page in the video description of this video. I'm very, very eager to get this LP started again. As you know, I played the press release version before, but that only went up to 12 days, so I'm really looking forward to getting back into this. So with that said, let's just start a new game here and see how we get on. Day one. I think they've changed the graphics here as well. I can't remember. I'd have to go back and check my previous videos for that. Alright, so this is our home base. And let's see who we've got as our group of survivors today. Looks like we've got three available. That's good. When the Civil War broke out, many people thought it would only last a couple of weeks. It's been years since government military surrounded the rebels in the capital, cutting off all supply lines. The civilian population trapped in the city is suffering from hunger, disease, and shelling. Katya met both Pavel and Bruno before the war. She used to be a reporter. While Bruno had his own television cooking show, Pavel was the star of the local football team. Katya even interviewed him once. Now they meet in dramatically different circumstances, looking for food and shelter. Okay, so we've got the same group of survivors as we had on the very first playthrough of the press release version, which is pretty cool. So Pavel is a fast runner, Bruno is a good cook, and Katya has good bargaining skills, so that's pretty good. Okay, so we're going to send Katya to search for that. And let's see what we can build, if anything yet. Oh no, okay, we're just sitting down on the chair. So the first thing I want to build today is going to be a metal workshop, but we need components and wood to do that. So let's unbarricade this. We'll send Pavel over here. Actually, you can run now, so we'll go do that. Bruno, you can go search this. Yep, we'll grab all. Exit. You go do that. Search that. You go up there and search that. We want to try and get as many items out of our home base at the start of the game as we can. Okay, so grab all that. And let's just pause the game. Oh, okay, no, I forgot about that. You can't issue commands while you're paused, which is a shame. But anyway, that's fine. So, okay, you can go and search that. And I guess, yeah, you start unbarricading that. Grab all. Alright, Pavel, let's get over here and see if we can build anything with the resources we have gathered. Okay, so we can build a metal workshop straight away, so we're going to do that. And we're going to place it right here next to our main crafting area. So the metal workshop is going to allow us to create weaponry, lockpicks, crowbars, all the stuff that we've got. excuse me. All the stuff that we're going to need to survive in this war of mine. Now, we do have a lockpick available. I'm just thinking that's probably going to be the best place to do it. Well, yeah, we need a shovel. So we should look at making a shovel. And we've got a shovel. Excellent. So we'll craft that right now. And once that's crafted, we can use the shovel to shift these piles of rubble. Yeah, so I want to prioritize this rubble and this. No, because we need a lockpick. We do have two lockpicks available, so we can actually do that. Okay, so Katya, you can go up here, use the shovel to start clearing this wreckage, and you can start clearing this. We'll use one lockpick on this wardrobe or cupboard here, and you can see he's using the shovel. That's cool. Okay, what else can we make? I'd love to make a knife, but we can't make a knife just yet. Crowbar, I think we'll save our components. As much as I would like to make one, think it'd be wiser to get some weaponry going first. Okay, so, Bruno, you can use a lockpick on here. And grab everything. We've got some meds, that's good. Don't have any food yet. Okay, what else can we craft? Alright, a moonshine still, I think, would be quite useful. We can make moonshine and use that for trading, so I think we're going to make that, and we'll place that right here, next to all our other crafting. Are you using your hands? Okay, come over here. Now go back there and use the shovel. There we go. Alright, so only one person can use the shovel at one time, so we need to either make a secondary shovel or... yeah, just take it in turns, basically. I've managed to keep warm in here, says Bruno. Well, we can see here the temperature. We can make a stove. Alright, so we need a fuel source, so we're going to... going to make one fuel source and we'll craft up some moonshine right now. Okay, so you make that. Bruno, let's have a look at what else we can make. Oh, we have some food available now, so that's good. Alright, we're going to make one bed and we're going to place this right here. Alright, so that's going to take an hour to do. Let's see what we need to upgrade our workshop. Alright, so we need components and we need wood. So I think we need to make this a priority so that we can make more items around the house. Also, what do we need to improve this? Lots more components and lots of wood. Alright, so realistically, our craft bench should be the first thing we upgrade, I think, because that takes less materials. So we'll do that first. Well, okay, so actually we might just make... let's use our second lockpick here. We might just make some weapons first, because there is a chance we can get raided on an evening. Oh, we need to get Pavel some medicine as well. Okay, well, that's a bandage, so actually we need medicine before we can do anything with that. Okay, what else can we do? Right, well, you search here. Okay, we've got some jewelry, so that's going to be useful for trading purposes. Okay, so we're coming up on the end of the first day. So at the end of the day, we're going to be able to send one person out on a loot run. Yeah, there we go. Someone should search for supplies at night. So we're going to leave these two guarding the base while we send probably Pavel, even though he's slightly sick. He's a fast runner, so he's pretty good for going out scavenging. So yeah, that's what we're going to do. 8 o'clock every night, we then go out scavenging. Okay, so go and pick that up. Alright. Okay, so we'll put Bruno on guard, we'll put Katya on guard, and Pavel can scavenge. And shelled cottage, semi-detached. Yeah, we're going to go to the shelled cottage first, so let's get prepared. Might be worth taking this with us. So we'll do that. No, actually, you know what? No. I want full backpack capacity. If we need the shovel, we're going to be coming back to this building anyway, because the chances are we're not going to be able to loot everything we need at one night. So that's fine. House is still burning. Is it safe to go inside? Well, I'm going to assume it is. Okay, so you can see here, this indicates that there is something moving around in there. Chances are it's just rats, though. So we should be okay. Yep, there goes the rat. We can actually use this icon to look through the door. Wow, okay, this is quite a good loot spot. Let's grab some 4, 8, 12. Yeah, okay, so that's probably enough components. So we'll grab some wood. Let's just leave 3 slots available. We'll go inside, we'll see what we have available in here, because I could really do with some meds or even some food. So I want to check the fridge right here. Alright, so normally I wouldn't run because that does make some noise. Okay, and we've found some food. So we'll grab that. And I think we will take this. This is sugar and it is used for brewing moonshine up. Alright, so we may as well just have a look around here, even though we can't carry anything else. Alright. Ideally, if we can find some meds, I will maybe leave something here and bring some meds back so we can heal Pavel up. And there we go, medications. So, I think we can afford to leave 2 of these, and we'll take that with us. Let's head downstairs. Alright, so we're going to need the shovel. We may as well just check the building out so we know exactly what we have available. More wood, that's good. Alright, so let's go upstairs. Like I say, normally I wouldn't run in buildings because you can see this little circle area around our character. That's indicating the sound he is making. Now, some of these buildings are going to contain enemies or friendly people, and running will alert them to our presence quicker than I would like. Alright, so we have loads and loads of components and wood here, so that's really good. It appears to be okay, so we need a lockpick as well to get in here. So we've used both our lockpicks up. We're going to need to craft a new one. So with that said, let's just get out of here. Oh, actually, hang on, wait. Let's check our backpack. Make sure we've maxed out everything that we can carry. So we can carry 4 components in one slot, 2 wood in one slot. So we've got everything that we can carry on us now, so that's good. We're not leaving here short of any materials. Okay, Pavel has arrived home. Hopefully we haven't been raided. I don't think we will have been because... Alright, so we're now on day 2. We should probably have enough to upgrade our workshop or even make some... I think we need weapon parts to make a knife, so chances are we won't get to do that. Okay, so Pavel is hungry, slightly sick and tired, so we're gonna bring him over here and give him some meds. So that will cure him. Okay, and now we're gonna send him to bed basically. Alright, so let's send Bruno down here. Actually, let's look and see if we can make a weapon. If we can make a couple of knives, or even just one knife, that would be extremely useful for defending our base. But as you can see here, we need 3 weapon parts, so we can't do that. But we can probably upgrade our workshop, so I think we should do that straight away. So, Katya, you can go and chill out in the chair over there, because you are getting a bit tired. Everyone's hungry, but we're going to hold off on making some food, because we can make a stove and have Bruno cook up the food, and then we'll get more out of the food. Oh no, sorry, that was the wrong character. So let's have a look and see what we can make now. So as you can see, we now have a bunch of extra things available. We can make a guitar, and that will brighten up our survivors' moods. We can make chairs for people to take a load off their feet. More importantly, we can board up holes and windows in the building for protection against looters. So this is pretty important, and as you can see, we need 2 components. Sorry, yes, 2 components, we have 5, and we need 10 wood. So that's good. We can also make a trap for small animals. These are very, they're kind of important. We can place these around our base and use them to trap rats, which are a good source of food, so we're probably going to do that soon as well. As you can see here, we can make a crude stove, we need 5 more components and 3 more wood. So we're probably going to focus on making that next, I think. Yes, you should have slept the last night, but you'll get a chance. So we're going to make up some more moonshine. Actually, that would use up all of our remaining water. So maybe we won't do that, actually. Alright, so we need some components, so we can't really craft that yet. Is there anything else we can do? Well, we can set somebody on this. We can actually access this, I think, anyway. Hopefully we can. So we'll send Bruno up here. He can use the shovel to clear this. Pavel is... Oh, okay, someone's at the door. So we're going to get to do a bit of trading here. So we'll send Katya, because Katya has better bargaining skills. Now remember, we have some jewelry and we have some moonshine available for trade. So this could be good. So we click here. These are all our items. These are all the items available for trade. And we can scroll down and see what is available. So first thing we want to do is select our jewelry. And you can see Franco here finds it interesting and he would like to make an exchange. So we'll do that and the moonshine. And we will buy... Now what are we going to buy? Well, let's have one lockpick. Some of those. So look at these. Luckily, these items are pretty cheap. So take some more water as well. Okay, so fine, we can have a deal, but we're going to keep pushing. Alright, so that's the limit. So we want to put a couple of those back. Let's get some more materials. There we go. Won't do, try harder. So we'll put one back. Yep, that's it for us. Right, so we're coming out of this pretty good. We've got a lockpick, a bunch of materials, some clean water, and yeah. So we'll click deal, and there we go. So we click the X, that will send that trader away, shut the door on him, and we've now got access to a bunch more materials. So we want to send Katya down here. We're going to make some more moonshine. Okay, so we need a lockpick to get through here, so should we use our lockpick here, I wonder? Right, we'll use one wood. Yeah, I wonder if we should use our lockpick there. Would it be useful anywhere else? It would to go looting, so I don't know, maybe we'll save that. Okay, so we're going to make some more moonshine. Alright, we'll leave this alone for now. Let's see if we can craft up anything else. You can come over here. Oh, that was my phone. Okay, so we can now make a crude stove. So I think we should make that. And we're going to place that in the kitchen next to the fridge. Seems like the most obvious place we should put it. Alright, we still can't make anything here, so that's fine. Still waiting on our moonshine to cook up. Once we get the stove up and running, we can send Bruno to cook some of this food up as well. So we'll probably do that. Still 16 degrees, so we don't need to make a heater just yet. But at some point soon, we are going to need to do that. Okay, so we now have... Let's just put you in that seat. We now have a stove available. So if we come up here... We send Bruno because he is our good cook. And you can see here we can craft up cooked food or a double cooked food. So we can get, we can actually use the vegetables alongside the raw food. This option just uses raw food, water, and a fuel source. But yeah, this is more nutritious and tastier, so it gets better by filling with vegetables. But we need more water and we need more fuel source, so we'll make one. Don't know that we want to. Let's just, yeah, we'll burn a book. I don't think that's good for your survivor's state of mind, but I kind of want to save my wood, so that's what we're going to do. And we're going to set him making some cooked food. Okay, so our moonshine's nearly done. We've almost got some cooked food. So Pavel is our scavenger, so I think he should get first dibs on the food. Yeah, I kind of want to craft some more, but I guess we're not going to be able to. So what we need to do is go back to that building we were at last night and fill up our bags with wood so we can make fuel sources. Okay, so now we've got some more moonshine. And actually, let me just pause the game. It looks like we're coming up on 20 minutes, guys. So I guess I'm going to call this the end of the episode here. Really hope you are enjoying this return to this war of mine. I'm certainly looking forward to playing some more of this and getting past day 12 to see what happens. But anyway, yeah, I'm going to call this the end of the episode, guys. Let me know in the comments what you think about this. I'm out for now, and I will see you soon for some more this war of mine. Peace.